வந்தே வாஞ்சித லாபாய கர்ம கிம் தன்ன கத்தியதே கிம் தம்பதி மிதி ப்ரூயாம் உதாகோ தம்பதி இதி நோ நீட் ஃபார் த ஸ்க்ரீன் வி வில் ஜஸ்ட் லுக் அட் த டெக்ஸ்ட் அண்ட் சரி ஸோ லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் வி லுக் அட் தட் ஸ்லோகா வேர் பிருஹஸ்பதி கம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஹீ ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் டு ஸ்பீக் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் த தேவாஸ் ரைட் அத்ராந்தரே சுரகுருஹ துரிதம் சுராணாம் அல்பாவசேஷம் அவயன் பிரணிதான யோகாத் அபியேத்ய நிர்ஜர வரைஹி அபிவந்திய பக்த்யா பர்யாவ்ருதஹ சதசி கிஞ்சித் இதம் அபபாஷே ஹீ ஸ்போக் ஜஸ்ட் அ லிட்டில் பிட் in order to give them encouragement. Don't be so dejected and talk to everybody who keeps going and coming. So understand that the end of your durita kala, the bad times that you have to face, is almost at the end, and your whatever is going to happen is going to be good from now on. So he says, he wants to start off with that, and he says in front of all the devas here, that is in the form of a gadya. Drishtya,
which page number is this?
It's 99 page number.
Just 1 minute, akka.
Yeah, sure.
Akka, engitta book illa.
Okay.
Drishtya va.
Drishtya. Drishtya means daiva vashat, luckily.
For, okay. Drishtya kushalino vashchirad
adraksham.
Adraksham. Oh, that is just one sentence.
Vaha chirat adraksham. So we'll go sentence by sentence. Dishtya kushalinaha vaha chirat adraksham. So daiva vashat, by good fortune or luckily, after a long time, chirat aham vaha kushalinaha vaha adraksham. This is in tvam. There is the second one that you will read, tubhyam te yuvabhyam vau yushmabhyam vaha, that portion. Most of the times you don't read the second word, you don't by heart it with the second word. So here, yeah. Vaha means yushman vaha. Kushalinaha yushman chirat aham adraksham, I saw you after a long time, luckily. Because he knew it is not dishtya or daiva vashat or anything, pranidhana yogat அல்பாவசேஷம் அவையன்னு ஹி ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் வித் தட் ரைட் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் சமாதி அண்ட் யோகா ஸ்டேட் தட் வாசஸ்பதி பிருஹஸ்பதி இஸ் இன் ஹி வாஸ் ஏபிள் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் தட் தேர் எண்ட் இஸ் கமிங் த ஷாப அந்தம் இஸ் தேர் அண்ட் ஹி கேன் மீட் தெம் திஷ்டியா
திஷ்டியா சோத்தீர்ண பிராயோப்ய பிராயோப்ய மாப மாபதர்ணவஹ
சோ பிராயஹ அயம் ஆபத் அர்ணவஹ திஷ்டியாச்ச லக்கிலி அகேன் உத்தீர்ணப்ராயா அயம் ஆபத் அர்ணவஹா ஆபத் இஸ் த மிஸ்ஃபார்ச்சூன் அண்ட் அர்ணவ இஸ் லைக் சாகரம் திஸ் மிஸ்ஃபார்ச்சூன் இஸ் லைக் ஒன் சாகரம் விச் கெனாட் பி ஐ கெனாட் சி தி எண்ட் ஆஃப் தட் ஓஷன் ஸோ ஓஷன் ஆஃப் மிஸ்ஃபார்ச்சூன் ஹேஸ் ஜஸ்ட் பாஸ்ட் உத்தீர்ணப்ராயா மீன்ஸ் இட் இஸ் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் டன் பாஸ்ட்
திஷ்ட்யா ச துர்லபம் இதம் தபோவனமஹோ பவத்பிஹி ஆசாதிதம்
As I told you before, this is a தபோவனம் This Mandara mountain is like a hermitage, ashrama of the sages. இதம் துர்லபம் தபோவனம் which is very difficult to attain. பவத்பிஹி ஆசாதிதம் You have attained this thing. You have come to this place which is very difficult for people to attain.
வாராணசீவ பாரதே வர்ஷே தைதம் கௌரி தைதஸ்ய பரமிதம் ஏவ ஏவ ஆயதனம் வா ஆயதனம் இளாவ்ருதேவ
இளாவ்ருதே தேர் ஆர் மெனி டிஃபரண்ட் வர்ஷஸ் யூ ஹேவ் சப்தத்வீபா வசுந்தரா சோ தேர் ஆர் செவன் டிஃபரண்ட் ஐலண்ட்ஸ் லைக் ஜம்பூ த்வீபா that is where Bharatavarsham is. But inside Jambu Dvipam, you have 9 different areas, which is Bharatavarsha, you have Kuru Varsha, Hiranmaya, Idavrita, Hari, Ramya, Ketumala, Bhadrashva, Kinnara, and Kinnara Varsha. These are the 9 different varieties of the Desha Vishesham, Varsha is Desha Vishesham. And nine are there. The details of all this you will find in Bhagavata Purana. In Bhagavatam, all of these things, what are the seven dvipas? And in each Varsha, in Jambudvipa, in Bharata Varsha, what are the most important places? In Ilavrata, what are the most important places? You have Meru Parvata in Ilavrata Varsha, Ilavrata Varsha. The Mandara Mountain is also found there. So just like how Varanasi is the most Punyakshetram in Bharata Varsha, the same way in Ilavrata Varsha, this Mandara Mountain is supposed to be a Punyakshetram of Shiva. So Bharata Varshe Varanasi Iva Gauri Daitasya Param Daitam Idam Ayatanam Ilavrite. Ilavrite Varshe in the country or in that Pradesham of Ilavrita, Gauri Daitasya, for the beloved of Gauri, which is Shiva, Shivasya, Idameva Param Daitam Param Ishtam Ayatanam Sthanam Punyakshetram Asti. Just like in Varanasi, you have Vishwanatha. Here also, Shiva has made this as his Ishtakshetra. Next.
So is Ilavrata, we have still considered that it's on Bhumi or no?
It is. It is in Jambudvipa. It is in Bhumi.
It is?
It is in, supposed to be in Bhumi.
Okay.
Bhumi is made of seven different islands. Saptadvipa. So in each one of those dvipam has different names. In that, Jambudvipam is one particular island where you have Bharata Varsham. And in that Jambudvipa, you have many different varshas, which is Ilavrata, Bharata, Kinnara, and all these are there. Kailasa is also supposed to be here only, right?
Correct, yeah.
So Kailasa, and near Kailasa is the Kinnara Varsha, where Kinnaras are supposed to live.
Oh.
So there are different portions inside the Jambudvipa, which is called Bharata Varsha, Ramya Varsha, Hari Varsha, and all that. I think Agnidhra is a king of Ilavrata. He was supposed to have established that.
Because last year one teacher in India, he happened to tell me one interesting thing, that Ketumala Varsha is present in Guatemala, and over time it got changed, you know, from Ketumala to Guatemala.
Interesting. Yeah. Very possible.
Yeah, no. Because apparently Bharata, the rishis in Bharata Varsha have named that Ketumala Varsha as that name because of Ketu's prabhavam. When it is night, morning in India, it is night in, you know, in this part of the country. And that is Ketu's prabhavam. You know, all the people who work at night and sleep during the day. Ketoho prabhavayena te ratro karyam kurvanti ataha ketumala varshaha iti nama agatam iti panditaihi uktam.
Possible. We don't know how they had imagined the earth and did it, right? So, highly possible. interesting information. Okay, next.
Arasat talada cha shantyatita kalabhuvanat santi mahanti sthanani sarvagama viditani parashatani bhavani patehe.
Bhavani patehe sarvagama viditani parashatani mahanti sthanani santi. There are many places of Bhavanipati, of Shiva, in this world, Bhuvane, Sarva Agama Viditani, which is known to all different Agamas. Agamas are those which are, Charya and Puja, which details the different Charya Puja of the Devatas. That is the Agama. So you have the Shaiva Agama, Vaishnava Agama, Pancharatra Agama. There are different types of Agamas there. And in all, and Vedas are also called as Agamas. So in every different types of Shastras, it is viditam, it is popular that Shiva has many different places, Punyakshetras. Parashatani, more than 100. This Parashata, Paras Koti, Paras Laksha, everything will have that Sakara in there. It is an Akritikana. Any number that you use and you want to say it is more than that number, you have to use Paras. before that. So Parashatani, Sarva Agama Viditani, Mahanti Sthanani, great places exist in this world. From where to where? A Rasatalat, from the Rasatala. So we have in the Chaturdasha Loka, we have Bhur, Bhuvaswar, Mahar, seven on top of Bhumi and seven below that. Atala, Sutala, Vitala, Patala. So you have until Rasatala. So Rasatalat, from the Rasatala to Shantyatita Loka. Shantyatita Loka, it has two meanings. One is inside our body. So our body is supposed to be the representation of the 14 lokas also. And physical representation is also there, where this Shantyatita Lokam is beyond this loka. What is that? Atikranta. Shanti Lokam is Akasham. In fact, Shantyatita Lokam is also said as Akasha. Shanti Loka is Akasha, and beyond that is your Shanti Atita Lokam. That is one point. The other thing is, Akantham Vidyaya Siddham, Alalatam Tu Shantaya, Tadurdhvam Shantyatitakhya Kalaya Parikalpitam. As a representation, if you see, Akantham, till the Kantham you have the Vidya. Vidya is, you know, the seven chakras that you have, that is, until that it is called the Vidya. And then after that, Alalatam, until the forehead, it is called Shanti. And then beyond the Shanti, where the Sahasraram is, that is called the Shantyatita Loka. Shantyatita Loka eva Shiva Parvatyoho and the Sahasrara irukkan solrom, yeah, that is, we say that they exist in that Sahasrara Padma. That is the Shiva's Loka, where you say Shantyatita Kala Bhuvanam. That is another Bhuvana, you call it. Here, if you see Akashe, Tarakalingam, Patale, Hatakeshwaram, in the Vyakhyanam he gives that. In each and every lokam, you have one specific Punyakshetram of Shiva. Where in Akasham, you have the Tarakalingam, Patale, Hatakeshwaraha, Martyaloke, Mahakala. In Martyalokam, whereas he says Varanasi here, but in Martyalokam, that is in Bhumi, you have Mahakala. In our lifetime, we have to go and visit that once. Mahakalam. You'll find different things. And in Shantyatita Lokam is where Shiva exists. Many different explanations are there for the Shantyatita Lokam. And I would prefer the explanation where he says that is Sahasrara Padma and where Shiva and Parvati are present. Okay. So, Rasatalat, Shantyatita Kala Bhuvanat, until that, from the Rasatala to the Shantyatita Loka, you have many different hundreds, more than hundreds of punyasthalas are there for Shiva. Param. But in all that, this place is the most beautiful place, which is Mandara Mountain. Param.
Param tu Mandara. Mandara iva tasya drisham na kinchana sundaram anyadayatanam.
Ayatanam. Anyat ayatanam, parantu tasya shivasya drisham. In Shiva's eyes, no other place is more beautiful than this Mandara Mountain. Mandaraha iva, like this Mandara Mountain, there is no other mountain, there is no other place. Kimapi anyat ayatanam na kinchana sundaram asti tasya drisham, for Shivasya drisham, for him. There is no other more beautiful.
Anyatra pancha tapasopi munehe avasatheshu shambhaveshu svairachari vishishyata iti shrutameva bhavadbhihi api vriddha mukhat.
Vriddha mukhat bhavadbhir api shrutameva. Vriddha mukhat, from people who are old, you have already heard so many things. Ancient people have kept on saying about the different punyakshetras of people. That is one thing. Another thing is, who is the bhakta who exults over other people? So, svairachari vishishyate iti shrutameva bhavadbihi. The one who goes on his own, that is avadhuta. Avadhuta, avadhutaha yaha vartate sayeva vishishyate. He is the most excellent of all the now avadhuta is that is why he says that is shambhaveshu avasateshu, those people who live in all these shambhusthana, in those places there are many people who are sitting there and doing panchatapas. This panchatapas, he explains it in six different ways in the Vyakhyanam. Very beautiful. I wanted to go through each and everything. Panchatapas means you have, so let me give the idea and then go to the panchatapas. So the more than the muni who performs this panchatapas, there is the one who roams around in all the Shivakshetras, who roams on their own, is better. Okay, that is the avadhuta purusha is always better than a person who is steeped in karma. The avadhuta is not a person who is who has not done karma or who is not doing karma. It is a person from whom the karma has gone away on its own. He has not left the karma. He has been performing the karma, but he has come to a stage where he is a Svairachari. He is not bound by any of these karmas and he is in that Shiva Dhyana Paraha. So he is an avadhuta here. So panchatapasaha munehe api Svairachari vishishyate, just like how you say, you know, Kalidasat bhavabhutihi vishishyate, in that manner. Here, that fifth case is used to say that a Svairachari is better. Avasateshu, Shambhaveshu, Avasateshu, Shambhu Sambandishu, Avasateshu, Sthaneshu, Yaha Svairachari Vartate, Saha Panchatapasaha Munehe Api Sreshtaha Vartate. That is, you know that yourself. Who is this Panchatapas Muni? One is Pancha Mahayajna Parataya. So the five different Mahayajnas are there. So Pitra Yajna, Deva Yajna, and all that. That is one type. The other is Panchagni Tapas. Panchagni Tapas is Dakshina, Garhapatya, Ahavaniya, Abhyava, Sabhya, and Avasatya. These are the five types of Agni Tapas. It could be that he is mentioning that Pancha Tapas Muni, or a combination of everybody, you can say, whether it is a person who performs the five yajna or whether it is a person who performs the five different types of agni tapas, that is a panchatapaha. Another pancha tapas is dana, yajna, swadhyaya, aikagriya, and anashana. These are all the five types of vratam. Danam is you perform charity, yajna is any type of yagam, swadhyaya you continuously do your own adhyayam, Aikagriyam Dhyanam, Anashana without any eating. That is a type of Vratam. One who follows the Pancha Vrata Karma Parayanaha. Another thing is Chandrayanadi, you know, there are great famous tapas like Chandrayanam and all. The one who follows those tapas, he could be that tapas also. That is also Pancha Tapas. Then you have Shiro Vratam, that is also five types of Vratam. He says, Atharvanikanam Brahmavidya Abhyasa Purvakale Kriyamananam Kriyamanam Yasya Saha Panchatapaha. Before you get into Brahmavidya, in Atharva Veda, there are five types of Shiro Vratam, which you have to follow, Vidibhat. That is also called Panchatapas. Even beyond that, an avadhuta is greater. So what he wants to say is you may follow any type of karmakandi. You may be a karmakandi. But one who is beyond that and one who pursues, is in the pursuit of that greater knowledge, is always better. Svairachari vishishyate iti shrutameva bhavadbihi vriddhamukhat.
Amrita prapti hetuhu.
अयम् अस्मादृशाम्
अयम् अस्मादृशामिव भवादृशामपि शैलराजः
अयम् शैलराजः दिस् माउंटेन किंग दिस् मंदरा माउंटेन अमृत प्राप्ति हेतुः अस्ति दिस् इज द हेतु इट इज द रीजन फॉर गेटिंग अमृत फॉर हूम अस्मादृशामिव जस्ट लाइक हाउ इट इज the place where we get Amrita, the same way you will also get amrita. Bhavadrisham api amrita prapti hetuhu idam ayam shailam shailaha, right? How is it? Amrita is a word which can mean both sudha and moksha. Sudha is nectar. Bhavadrisham api sudha prapti hetuhu ayam shailarajaha. I am Achalaha. This mountain is the reason for you to get Amritam, which is Sudha or Nectar. You are going to use Mandara Mountain as the Manthana Rupena, Mandaram Upayujya, Sudham, you will get it. Right? Whereas for us, Asmadrishamiva, we know that this is the great Punyakshetra of Shiva. So we always come here to do Shiva Dhyanam and we get Amritatvam. Amritatvam Ashnute. What is that Amritatvam? That is Brahmavitya. So that Swayam Prakasha Swarupa Brahma is called Amritatvam because the moment you get that Brahma Jnana, there is no relapse that you go back into this world and you are experiencing all these bhoga. You will never get back into that. So Amritatvam, where there is no returning, that is your Brahma Jnana. That is moksha. So moksha prapti hetuhu asmadrisham iti purvameva jnatam kintu adhuna bhavadrisham api amrita prapti hetuhu bhavati ayam shailaha. How is it? Because later you are going to use this as a manthana. Right? So that's a beautiful, what is that alankaram here? Sama alankaram. Amrita prapti hetuhu asmadrisham iva bhavadrisham api. Correct? Kim bahuna? No, he says you should not waste your time here and you should start doing something about it. Get up and start going to, go to Brahma and ask him what you want, what the next course of action is. That is this shloka here. Kim bahuna?
Kim bahuna? Kalo atyaga dashu.
Ashubha. Ashubha hetuhu.
Ashubha hetuhu upasthitam vaha kalyanam adyana chiraditi bhasate naha uttishtot chalata yamatu dhama dhatuhu ushtrasikabhi radhuna kimanarthikabhihi.
Kalo atyagat ashubha hetu upasthitam vaha kalyanam adyana chiraditi bhasate naha. So first thing he says, kalaha atyagat. What time has gone now? Ashubha hetuhu. Ashubha hetuhu kalaha atyagat. The time for an ashubha kalam has gone now. Ill fortune time. That ashubha hetuhu kalaha yaha saha atigataha. It has left or it has passed. It is not near. Okay, it is gone for you. Adya, what is upasthitam vaha upasthitam. Something is nearby. What is nearby? Kalyanam adya bhavataha upasthitam. Bhavatam upasthitam. So vaha kalyanam adya upasthitam. Good time is present near. Upasthitam means samipe sthitaha. Na chirat iti naha bhasate. I think the perfect time or the good time for you is here, is present, na chirat. Not for long are you going to experience a good time. Iti naha bhasate asmakam chitte udeti or spurati. Uttishtata, uchalata, yamatu dhama dhatuhu. So where do you, uttishtata, what is that? Vivekananda came later and he used this from Katopanishad actually. Uttishtata, jagrata, prapyavaran, nibodhata, kshurasya, it's like the knife edge. You cannot, you have to start working towards your, that is only for atma bodha. You have to make an effort to get that brahma jnana. You cannot just sit and say that jnanam will come when it has to come and depend on fate for that. That is where the fate and free will tug of war happens, right? You cannot just sit and say, Daivena deyamiti kapurushaha vadanti. Daivam mihatya kuru paurusham atma shaktya. You have to make an effort with your atma shaktya. That is when you can achieve anything. Ashubheshu samavishtam shubheshweva avatarayet. You have to make an effort to, even though your brain is constantly telling you that it is an Ashubha Kala for you, you have to take that Sarit and put it into the that thought process and put it into the something good. Otherwise, nothing is going to happen. The Vasana Sarit, that Samskara Sarit is like Shubha and Ashubha Sarit keeps on going in your mind. Shubha Vasana and Ashubha Vasana. But what do you have to do? Ashubheshu Samavishtam. If your mind is in Ashubha, you have to take that forcibly and put it into Shubha. That is in your hands. As you keep on trying to put your thought process, Chitta Vritti, into the Shubha Vasana, it will automatically become a habit at some point and make you think only positively. So that is very important. So he says, Uttishtata, Uchalata, you have to get up and start moving towards Brahma's abode so that he will give you some solution to what as to what to do about it. Dhatuhu dhama yama. Dhatuhu dhama, dhatuhu ayatanam, sthanam, yama. Let's go. You know, let us go and see Brahma and decide what to do about this. Uchalata, let us go. You know, do something about it. Says, Adhuna, kim anarthikabhi, anarthikabhihi, ushtrasikabhihi, adhuna kim, kim prayojana. Ushtrasika, ushtrasika means ushtram, ushtraiva asanam or ushtraiva asyante iti, ushtrasyaiva asyante. Just like a camel is constantly sitting and it is not doing anything, no action, it will just keep on looking with its necking, you know, and it just stretches its neck and keeps seeing what is happening, what is happening. That is how you're all behaving. You're just sitting in this Mandara mountain, just extending your neck and going, whoever keeps coming and going, you're asking them what is happening. You know, when the Karmadevas come down, how are the asuras doing there? When the those who are going towards moksha, please go and tell Brahma that we are also there, ask him not to forget about us. That is not how you have to behave. You have to put in an effort, he says. Uttishtata, uchalata, yamatu dhama dhatuhu, ushtrasikabihi, kutrabi gavanam vina atreiva, you know, sthitva, you are just looking at that. Kantham unnamaya pasyanti ye ushtraiva tesham ushtrasika. So anarthika, there is no prayojanam in that. So anarthikabhihi ushtrasikabhihi kim prayojanam adhuna. So let's go. Kalo atyagat ashubahetuhu. Kalo atyagat ashubahetur upasthitam vaha. Kalyanam adhya nachirad iti bhasate naha. Uttishtato uchalata yamatu dhama dhatuhu. Ushtrasikabhi raduna kim anarthikabhihi. Iti pravrittaya. Now, as Vachaspati spoke like this, the moment he stopped, Indra started to talk. And he said, okay, you know, we should not be like this and we have to, I understand that the moment I've seen you, I realize that, you know, our bad times are gone and we have to start looking forward towards the good times. Because someone has to come and back prod, right? Otherwise, people will just keep on sitting there. This is the problem even with Devas.
Iti pravrittaya. Bhavi bhavim aham aham aha
samvidhana. Bhavi maha samvidhana.
Bhavi maha samvidhana alabhyayapi bhagyavashad adhunaiva svato labdhaya sudhayeva vacha vachaspatehe apyayita apyayita surapatihi idam achakshe.
Iti pravrittaya sudhaya vacha vachaspatehe apyayitaha surapatihi idam achakshe. Surapatihi Indra said the following. Idam achakshe, he spoke the forthcoming words. What are he is going to say, the Indra's words now. How was Surapati? The visheshana he gives is vachaspatehe vacha apyayitaha. He was completely submerged by Vachaspati's words. How was the words? Sudhaya iva. It was nectar-like words that he said. You know, kalo atyagat ashubahetuhu kalaha atyagat kalyanam adya upasthita. When someone says that, you know, all your misfortune is gone and you are going to face only good times ahead, good times are ahead. then it is like அப்படியே அமிர்தம் பொழிஞ்ச மாதிரி இருக்கும்ல. சுதயா வாச்சா அப்யாயிதா பிளாவிதா இவ இஸ் சப்மர்ஜ்ட் இன் தட் நெக்டர் லைக் வேர்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் பிருஹஸ்பதி. நோ, இட் வாஸ் ஆஸ் இஃப் இட் வாஸ் அன் இண்டிகேட்டிவ் ஆஃப் த ஃபேக்ட் தட் தே ஆர் கோயிங் டு கெட் தட் சுதா அகேன். ஸ்வதா லப்தயா சுதயா இவ ஆஸ் இஃப் தே ஹட் காட்டன் இட் பாக்யவசாத் அதுனைவ லப்தயா. By, you know, by fortunately, it was as if they had got that Sudha now itself. Being drenched in that nectar which will be got later. Bhavi maha samvidhana labhyaya api. Even though they were going to get it, labhyaya, even though they were going to get it later. How? Bhavi, in the future. How are they going to get it? Mahasamvidhanam. Samvidhanam is Mahasangam. Samvidhana is actually effort. Mahaprayatnena bhavi bhavishyat kale labhya sudha. Api, even though it was going to be attained by a great effort. What were the great effort? Brihaspati will go and talk to, you know, they will tell you'll have to go and talk to Asura. So Brihaspati will talk to Shukra. Shukra will talk to Asura. All these things will happen. And then they both will come together. Then they will have to bring the Mandara mountain and all that effort is there, right? We know the story beforehand. But it is as if, even though it was going to be done with a great effort, it was as if this God, they got it in a very easy manner now. The moment he said, it was an indication that what is going to happen later. Labdhaya sudhaya iva bhagyavashat aduna iva swataha labdhaya. It was as if that amrita came on its own to them on the, in their hands. Tatha vidha vachaya vacha vachaspatehe vacha apyayitaha surapatihi. He was submerged or drenched in that nectar. Surapatihi idam achachake. He started his words. So Indrasya vachana. What did he say?
Adyaitat. Pavana, pavanam ajani tapovanam adya nastapamsi paripechire prashem muradya naha
kalushani
kalushani paryupasthishata mangalani பரதா கதம் பவதியானாம் பாத்ரி பவேம சாசனாக்ஷராணாம்
பவதியானாம் சாசன அக்ஷராணாம் பாத்ரி பவேம கதம் பாத்ரி பவேம. See, we have become a recipient of your advice. How can we be a recipient of Brihaspati's advice if our ill fortune is almost over and good times are going to come? This is just an indication that, you know, good, only good is going to happen for us. So he says, adya etat tapovanam, this tapovanam, this mandara mountain is called tapovanam, pavanam ajani, it has become pure because of your presence here, right? So this tapovanam has become pure. Adya naha tapamsi paripechire paripakam abhuvan naha tapamsi, our tapas, all the tapas that we have had, we have been doing so far, have become, it is not attained fruition, or it is paripaka abhimukam abhuvan. They have become towards they are facing the point of fruition. Okay, so that is, we have been doing tapas so long, and we are ready to experience the good merits that are going to come for it. So adya naha asmakam tapamsi paripechire paripapka abhimukam abhavan prashemuhu adya naha kalushani. Naha kalushani adya asmakam kalushani, the difficulties that we have had, not the papam. It is talking about the durita kalam that they have had so far, the apat that they have been experiencing so far. Naha kalushani adya prashemuhu, they have been destroyed. Paryupasthishata mangalani. Mangalani, auspicious things are near. here upatasthe is actually upasthishata is the lung lakara of sthadatu with upa pari and upa upasarga here. It is used for sangati karana. It is not for, see, usually when you use upa and sthadatu, it is for deva puja or mantra upang mantra karane is the sutram that he uses. Panini uses that sutram where you say upatasthe means you have to use with veda mantra, you are praising the god. That is where you use upa upasarga with sthadatu. It is called stotra karanam. And deva puja, you can use it for deva puja. There are many different meanings with which you can use this upasargam. You cannot use all upasargam with every dhatu here. It's very specific with which dhatu, with when the upasarga is used with this particular dhatu, the meaning itself is changed and it is applied only in certain meanings. Here it is sangati karanam is the meaning that he uses. If you look at the tika, he says that upat deva puja sangati karana mitra karana pathishu iti vachyam. Based on that vartikam he uses. See, Neelakanta Dikshita is so pakka with his grammar. Sangati karanam means mangalani aduna sangachante. How can that happen? How can auspicious things come for them? Paratha, anyatha, otherwise, how can we get such shasana aksharanam patri bhavema? How can we become the recipient of such wonderful upadesha from you? Right? He gives a good pep talk. Now, Indra praises Brihaspati's intellect. Cheto yad bhavataha. Read that shloka. It's just one samasta padam is given.
Cheto yad bhavataha chiranta nava navacharas sandarbha garbha sthite vastunyasta nyastamita nyastam ita prapancha malina.
Try to split it because the splitting itself is will be very difficult to do it.
Prapancha malinimnayam majja mam majjati.
Tad durme durmoch. It's a sloka, no? So you have another pada also.
Taddurmochata mochata mo vimohita matishvasmasvaka
akasmat idam.
Akasmat idam saktam yat pashushu dvipasvapi tato dhanya vayam nyanyataha.
Nyayataha.
Nyayataha.
Cheto yad bhavataha chirantana vachaha sandarbha garbhasthite vastuni astamita prapancha malinimni amajjam amajjati. Vastuni astamita prapancha malinimni amajjam amajjati taddurmocha tamo vimohita matishu asmasu akasmat idam saktam yat pashusu pashushu dvipatsu api tato dhanya vayam nyayataha. He says, dhanya vayam nyayataha. We are very great, very fortunate to have your presence here. He says, yat bhavataha chetaha, your chetas, your mind is amajjam amajjati. It is constantly in that vastuni. So the main sentence, the first part is, yat bhavataha chetaha vastuni amajjam amajjati. That is the main part of the first part. So bhavataha chetaha, your mind is constantly thinking about that vastu. What is that vastu? Parabrahma swarupa. Brahmani, brahma namni vastuni amajjati. It is constantly submerging itself in that brahmajnana. Brahmajnane eva asti bhavataha chetaha. Amajjam avajjati, that kriya visheshanam he gives here is amajjam completely. Majja sharira bhutam is, majja is usually we talk about the what is that flesh and all that. So all your entire body is submerged in it. You can't take it that way here. Here, majjam is shuddham. Asamantat shuddham yat tathavidam. Or majja is sara. Saraha, sarabhutam, that which is the essence. What is the essence? So, sukshmataya yad veditavyam tadapi veti bhagavan. That is how he uses this amajjam. So, asaram amajjati. To understand the entire essence of that Brahmajnana, you have submerged, your mind is constantly thinking about aikagra chittena, your mind is constantly thinking about that Brahman. How is that Brahman? He gives two adjectives to this Brahman. Chirantana vachas sandarbha garbhastite vastuni. And then astamita prapancha malinimnyam. Malinimni vastuni. Yatu vastu sandarbhachas sandarbha chirantana vachas sandarbha garbhastite vastuni. Yatad vastu chirantana vachaha is shruti vachaha. So shruti naam vachamsi tesham sandarbaha it this Brahma Swarupam is only known by Shastra. We only know from the Veda Vakyam. Vedaika Vedyam, that is the meaning of this adjective. He says Vedaika Vedye Brahmani Tava Chetaha Majjati. So what does it mean? Chirantana Vachaha. Puratana Vachaha is Shruti. Shruti Vakyam or Vedas. And the Vedas, their sandarbha, sandarbha is of five types here. Upakrama, upasamhara, abhyasa, apurvata phalam. Arthavada upapatti. Tappa solren. Upakrama, upasamhara, abhyaso, apurvata phalam. Arthavada upapatti cha lingam tatparya nirnaye. In order to understand what the Shrutis or the Vedas are saying, we use upakrama, that is in introduction, upasamhara and ending, abhyasa, if it continuously keeps on saying about the Brahman, yatova imani bhutani jayante, yenava jatani jivanti, yat prayanti abhisambhishanti, tad vijignyasasva, tad brahma. This is the Veda Vakyam, that is the Shruti Vakyam or the Upanishad Vakyam that you, from which you learned that from the Brahman this entire world has come about. Yatova imani bhutani jayante. Yenava imani jivanti, yena jatani jivanti. Those which have been born are sustained because of him. Yet prayanti abhisam vishanti, those which go towards him and become leena there. Tat vijignyasasva, know that to be Brahman. Tat vijignyasasva, tat Brahma. That is the Brahma Swarupa. From where all this entire 14 worlds have come out and the Srishti, Sthiti and Layam happen because of that person. This is what the Veda Vakyam says. So it starts off with that and it also ends with that and it repeatedly keeps on saying about only that Brahman, Abhyasa. And then Arthavada, it also talks about great things about this Brahman. Upapatti, Lingam, these are all the things that you use to understand what the Shruti talks about. So with these in hand, these are like your rules to understand Veda. That is the Sandarbha. So it's not just Shruti, Sandarbha, Garbhasthite means Sandarbha talks about these four, five things. Upakrama, Upasamhara, Abhyasa and all that. Based on these things, you understand what contextually the Shruti Vakya gives us. That is the Garbhasthitam Artham. Chirantana Vachaha Veda Vakyeshu Sandarbhena Yat Garbhasthitam Artham Jnayate. What is that Artham that we understand from the Shruti Vakya? Vastu. That is your Brahma Swarupa. And how is it relevant to us? What Shruti says is what Shruti says, I'm fine. But how is it relevant to us? Astamita prapancha malinimni. This prapancha is the malinyam, or it is the not dirt or kalushyam, that is the avidya, avidyavad vishayanyeva pratyakshadini pramanani shastrani cha. Everything that you see in this world, including the shastram that you read, is based on avidya or maya. That is your prapancha swarupam. which is malinyam, which has to be removed in order to understand that Brahma Swarupa. That Brahma Swarupa is of the form of Astamita Prapancha Malinyam. This Prapancha, it is not, see, when there are not two different objects, you know, avidya is removed, avidya is maya. When the maya is removed and then the Brahma Swarupa is seen, there are no two things there. There is the removal of avidya is equal to Brahma Jnana. That is what he says here. Astamita, when prapancha malinyam astamitam bhavati, tat swarupam Brahma. That is why he uses both as an adjective here. Okay. This is just the essence of the Chatusutri, of the four sutras that are there in Brahma Sutra. Astamita prapancha malinya rupa brahmani bhavat chetaha amachati. It is constantly in that Brahma Swarupa. Okay. 1 minute. I will start. So, tad durmocha tamo vimohita matishu asmasu pashusu dvipatsu api idam saktam iti chetu vayam dhanyaha. So we are all fortunate to have that mind of yours attached to us also. See, you are constantly thinking about Brahman and yet you have come out of that state and you are thinking of our good fortune and you want to do something good for us, then it means that dhanyaha vayam, we are indeed fortunate to have you also think in that chetas. Yet bhavataha chetasaha chetaha amajjati tat chetaha idam tat idam chetaha. So that chetas which is constantly contemplating on the Brahman, now in front of us in the form of you, idam saktam, kutra saktam, asmasu saktam. How are we? Devas, he is collectively talking about all the devas and saying pashushu. See, pashu in the it is not just agnyata vishaye, because we are all we don't have that intellect, aviveki. In order to say that he is an aviveki, he does not have nityanatya vastu viveka, is not present in the devas. He wants to point out that and he says, I am like a pashu. Okay, so pashushu dvipatsu, even though I'm talking of me as pashu, but we have only two legs, right? So dvipatsu pashushu asmasu, how are we? Further, another adjective he gives for himself. Durmocha tamo vimohita matishu. Our minds are vimohita. It is completely deluded by moha, tamas. What is that tamas? That is avidya, maya. Maya swarupam. And durmocha, it is very difficult to get out of that maya. Right? We constantly keep looking at these vishayas that are there in the world and we are being pulled by it, right? By different you'll say a bhramaram will only get attracted by that smell and it wants that nectar, whereas we have five different sense organs and we are being attracted by it. Even the devas are like that. So durmocha, it is very difficult to get out of that vishaya asakti. So durmocha tamo vimohita matishu, our mati, our brains are completely deluded by this tamas, and we are equal to pashu. But we have only two legs, so it is better. Huh? That is a Vyatireka Alankara there. Dvipatsu, pashushu, asmasu, idam saktam. Idam saktam, it is, you have shown a great love towards us because you have come and shown this, you are attached towards us also. Tataha dvayam dhanyaha. That means we are very fortunate. Nyayataha means yukti vashena. This is Kavilinga Alankaram here. By that process, I understand. Even though you are constantly in Brahma Swarupa, your mind is attached to us also and you are thinking of our good in your mind and you are coming and addressing us in this manner. I understand from this yukti that we are fortunate. It only shows our fortunate, fortune, good fortune that you have come and shown your advice. You have given us this advice. Tad durmocha tamo vimohita matishu. He's just put it in one nutshell here. You have to explain the entire Advaita Vedanta. Have that in your mind to know the shloka, to understand the import of the shloka. Pa. Cheto yad bhavatas chirantana vachas sandarbha garbhasthite vastuni astamita prapancha malinimni amajjam avajjati. Yad tad durmocha tamo vimohita matishu asmasu akasmat idam. They did not expect that Brihaspati was going to come. He suddenly came there. Right? Akasmat idam saktam yat pashushu dvipatsu api tato dhanya vayam nyayatah. Beautiful shloka. We'll stop with this. Okay. Any doubt?